If you're new to my channel, my name is Princella Stringer and I'm an empowerment coach, and I love to do videos that on many different topics that empower you to seek your goals, as I just talked about. That's what all of these videos are for, dedicated to you, and I would love to hear from you what you would love to hear about. If there's something that's holding you back from achieving your goal, send me a message and let me know, and I'd love to talk about it in one of my videos. So I hope it helps you and serves you in that way. Also, if you're new to this page, like the page, really helps a lot. If you just like it and watch the videos, if a video inspires you or you have some thoughts on it, leave a comment and share your thoughts. So on that note, I want to switch gears a little bit and talk to Sarah, invite her on. I'm so excited you're here, Sarah, to talk about this topic, to talk about what you do in your business, and to talk about what you feel Limitless Woman means to you. But let's first start off with, what do you do in your business? Tell us a little bit about that and what you do today.
Yeah. So first off, thank you for having me. I love being on stuff like this. So this is wonderful. Awesome. So I teach people how to conquer their pain, how to have less pain and more energy and find a more joyful life. And so a lot of that has to do with being limitless. And people who struggle with a lot of pain, whether that's migraines or back pain or, you know, any other type of pain, really feel limited in that. And so part of getting out of that is having the courage to break that pain cycle, to take control of your life. And then as that starts to happen, it becomes it's like cyclical. And then you want to feel better and you want to eat better and you want to feel better and have more energy and less pain. And it continues, which is really, really awesome. But taking that first step is sometimes really hard for people, especially if you've been sort of stuck in your pain or stuck in bad health for several months or years, sometimes for some people. So that is really awesome.
Yeah. And I believe it, because once you start living with the pain, you're like, well, this is life. This is just what I have to deal with. And we don't think that there is a way to change it. A very, very small example. I mean, there are women that deal with much more pain than I ever had to deal with. But I used to, in the mornings, I used to have just a really hard time getting up, and I'd feel this swelling and pain in my legs. And getting up in the morning was like, ugh. Like I used to think in my mind, I hate mornings. Luckily, that's all changed, and I don't think that way anymore. And it had a lot to do with my mindset, and also my eating habits were really affecting that. Megan and I talked about that just a little bit, how eating habits affect your mood and how you feel. So I'm excited to talk to you about another piece of that, which is a physical pain in our body that we really believe we can't do anything about.
Yeah, definitely. It's sort of one of those things where, like I said, it's a cycle, both negatively, a downward spiral, where you start having pain and then you withdraw from social activity, from activity in general. And it doesn't have to be exercise, just doing things, whether that's cooking dinner or cleaning or going shopping or grocery shopping. It doesn't matter. But it really affects our everyday life when we have pain, and then it causes a lot of depression and things like that. And so really what I try to focus on is sort of that empowerment aspect, in that you have the power. And if you're going to have pain, no matter what, you might as well have fun. You might as well do the things you need to do and go out for coffee and have a good piece of pie or whatever else you want to do. But in that, people find that they do have a lot less pain. And then we teach people tons of different tools and techniques that go along with stress management and relaxation and different things like that. Gentle exercise. It's not, nobody's asking you to start CrossFit here or anything like that. We're just really focused on feeling good, and really it makes a big, big difference in people's lives.
Yeah. So in other words, if you're listening to this as an audience viewer and you're faced with pain and you're worried about seeking help because you're worried about what they're going to try to put your body through, you know, Sarah's saying that you don't have to jump into something extreme. It's a process, right?
Right, absolutely. Absolutely. And there are small shifts that you can make in your everyday life that it doesn't take a time commitment. You're doing things anyway. Just little shifts can compound to make a huge difference.
Yeah, awesome. I hope that helps somebody today, because living with pain is no joke. Oh my gosh. And so to know that there might be another option with that. But so as a matter of fact, if anybody has any thoughts, if you're watching this video right now and this resonates with you, leave a comment. Sarah will come back and I'll make sure she sees the message to respond to questions that you have. So I'd love for any questions that you have regarding that. Put it in the comments and we'll make sure we get back to you. But so on that note, I'd like to ask you, this is probably a lot of that is probably a lot similar to or very similar to what you'll talk about at the event, right? Did you want to share anything else about visiting us in Michigan? How far do you live from here anyway, by the way?
Yeah, so I am between sort of Saginaw and Alma. So it'll be, I think, like a 2.5 hour drive. But my sister lives down in that area. So I plan on just spending the weekend with her and having some fun.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice. Enjoy the beach, right? Yeah. S
Absolutely. It's beautiful.
yes. So I invite you to come on August 17th and hear what Sarah has to say about pain management and mindset around that and steps that you can take around that to feel better. Oh, question just popped in my mind.
Yes.
How many of your clients or how many people really talk about that they just don't think about it anymore and that seemed to help them kind of ease the pain. Does that come into play at all, or is it that
Yeah,
the exercises help?
everyone says that. And so people who have a lot of pain are like, what do you mean don't think about it anymore? I can't not think about it anymore. But one of the things that we teach is using your time to be constructive, and also having time for downtime, time for rest, and then being helpful, being constructive, working. Or if you're retired or you're not working, that's fine too. But doing things that sort of gets you out of your own head, and because that's a lot of our biggest struggle. And so part of that is volunteering. If you think you have a lot of pain, go and do something helpful for someone else. I found this quote and it said, nobody can change the world, but everybody can change, or everybody has a way that they can contribute. And I think a lot about people who just live in debilitating pain and becoming sort of like a different. There's several things you can do. You can be a prayer warrior. You can volunteer to hold babies in the neonatal unit. You can volunteer to nurse cats at the Humane Society. I mean, things that really feed the soul and just warm your heart aren't going to make your pain any worse, and they will make you feel better. It gets you out of the house and doing something fun, and it really just helps to help you to focus on something else. And that absolutely is a really key component, Priscilla. I'm glad that you brought that up because I think that that's where we get the most stuck, and that's really important. But it is hard to get over that in the beginning. You're like, I can't not think about it. You're crazy. You have no idea what you're talking about, you know. But after you try it really has a big takes a big effect, which is really cool to see.
Wow. I love, love, love your approach. Helping people to really think, get their mind off of it. Yeah, and who knew it would be possible? But on that note, I'm really excited to hear. We've chatted a little bit about this, and I know that you have some thoughts on this. So, what are your thoughts about what it means to be a limitless woman?
Yeah, so I think that being a limitless woman means that you have the courage to get whatever you want. And for some people, that's chase their dreams. Maybe they want to start a business or get a promotion or have a family or run a marathon or write a book. It doesn't matter. Yeah, whatever you want to do. And that's the beauty of being a limitless woman, is that you are not held back. And a lot of it, you know, some people say society holds us back, but I think a lot more often than society, it's our own expectations and what we fear other people will say. You know, I'm always worried about whatever, my mother-in-law or my sister or my friend or the neighbor, you know? And so I think being a limitless woman comes down to courage and having the bravery to do whatever you want to do. And that can
Right.
be big things or small things. And that is yours. That is yours to own. And nobody gets an opinion in what you want to do because that's all you.
Love that. Oh my gosh, that is so inspiring. That is so awesome. So what brought you to owning your own business, taking the steps that you've taken in your life? I mean, was there an influence in your life that kind of paved that way, or did you do like self-reflection and development to get yourself to the place where you are today, or how'd you get here?
God did it all. I am the first to
Amen.
say that. God did it all. So I graduated with my bachelor's degree, started working, treating or teaching a yoga for oncology patients program, and really, really loved it. Really found a passion with working with seniors and different things like that. But I knew that I could make a bigger difference if I were out on my own, just because there's so much red tape within large organizations, and you can just move so much quicker when you're by yourself. And so I went out and started my own business, and then along the way, God has just thrown me so many opportunities, and it has morphed and become this incredible, incredible program that we call Conquer Your Pain. And it's just incredible. And God did every single part of this. I feel that God has given me a gift, and it's my job to steward that. But all my ideas, everything that has come about has come straight from him. And but I do think that part of following this dream and chasing this dream is I tap into the 17-year-old version of myself. Like, I was a maniac, okay? And part of it is that you have to have the courage to do that, to chase your dreams, to be limitless, to do all those things. And the me version has little anxiety, and I'm a little more cautious. But when I need a dose of reality or a little courage, I just say, okay, what would the 17-year-old me do? She would go for it all in 150%. And so I just really, really think that that's really important. And there's a
So
movie
important.
that it said sometimes it takes 10, or I don't know, 5 seconds of insane encouragement, and that'll change your life. And I try to do that every day,
Oh
and
my
it has
gosh.
really, really been incredible for me.
I
And
love
so I
it.
think that that's really key too. And I'm just glad that I can tap into that, I guess.
Yes, absolutely. As a matter of fact, that reminds me, a couple days ago, I did a post of this image of my daughter and both of my kids, my son and my daughter, they just have this amazing confidence right now, like, yeah, I can do that, you know. And at their age, I don't think I had that. I had that confidence. I don't know exactly what was going on in my world or in my mind at that time. I had a good family upbringing and things like that, but I did. I lacked confidence. I guess it was something just innate in me at their age. But anyway, my point is this image of my daughter holding her camera because she's a photographer and she's only 15, or she will be 15 in August. August, November. It's my other daughter, my stepdaughter. Anyway, point is that the confidence that she exudes in this image, in this photo, and I wrote a small blog post about, remember when you were a teenager and you felt like, I know everything. Of course I'll
You
do
can
it.
take
Of
on
course I can do it.
the
You could take on the world, really.
world.
Yes. So I love that you said that you tap into that when you need that energy again and just kind of pull it out. You pull it out of yourself. That's awesome. So cool. So I'm so excited that you got to come on and share a little bit about what you do in your business and kind of a little sneak peek of what you'll talk about on August 17th. and sharing your insight about the limitless woman mindset. A lot of people ask this question, well, what about men? You know, we need to have this limitless mindset too. So, and you know, if I have any guys out there watching this video too, I mean, it's all from the same thought process on having a limitless mindset. Matter of fact, if there are any men that are joining us, I'd love to hear from you and see if you have an interest in this topic too, where you know, so I feel like the female brain and the male brain, I just have a different perspective on it, so you may use different language in talking about this. Maybe yes, maybe no, maybe I'm wrong, I don't know. But I'd love to hear thoughts from people that are watching, what you think about that. Also, what are your thoughts about this video in particular and what we talked about today? As I mentioned earlier, if you have any questions about what Sarah does in particular, leave a message there and we'll get back to you on those questions. But I'm so excited that you were here to talk about this. This opened up a whole can of worms of conversations that is so important to have. And once we get that out there and plant one little seed in somebody, to really excite them to think about what is that long lost dream that I don't think about anymore, or that I convinced myself that I cannot go after for whatever reason. Maybe it's because of the pain you're facing. Maybe it's because of the age you are. You know, whatever the reason is, I hope this or one of our videos inspires you to tap into that, tap into your 17-year-old self, as Sarah says, and find that drive and that mission to dig a little bit deeper into the goals and the plans that you once upon a time had and revive them. I'd love to hear your stories on how this has helped you and inspired you to do that. So thanks again, Sarah, for joining me. I was so thrilled that we just kind of decided yesterday, didn't we? We're like, let's just do it. Let's just do the video today, right? So I'm so glad that you were flexible to just hop on. It was so good to chat with you about this topic.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me. This was wonderful.
So I will talk to you soon. And anybody joining, make sure you like and subscribe to this channel. This is not YouTube. Oh, why did I say subscribe? But like the Facebook page. I'd love to hear from you and hear your thoughts. So have a great day, everybody.